Is health and safety. The first S is about that. Are you waiting for government to put down a lockdown before you stop asking employees to come to office, or you are already proactive and you are taking care of their health?
Right. Well, men, I wouldn't say all men, but most of the men decide to focus on their work and many times do not offer to help with childcare and household chores or cooking. So it's like women have to multitask and they become the sole responsibility of to kind of efficiently manage both work and home.
In the armed forces, it is really deep employee engagement. You need to have the motivation and morale of the soldier or the officer, anyone who is putting on the uniform, so high that the person doesn't think, you know, even twice to lay the life for the nation.
50% additional dropout rate in people joining the organization, and then there is a 12% higher rate of people attriting, you know, turning over from the organization. So it's like it's becoming so crucial for employers to kind of really plan to retain people.
I think change is the name of the game, and only winning strategy is through adaptability and learning agility. So learning is nowhere to go. It is going to actually increase much more.